she dressed herself in blue. I want you to tell me of the long, long love between Lady Margaret and you. Of her love I can say on this morning in May, but I don't think that she loves me. And tomorrow early morn I'll ride to the church, Lady Margaret my bride shall see. Lady Margaret was sitting in her high sewing room, she was combing back her yellow hair. She saw her lover William walking with his new bride, as to the church door they drew near. When she saw the couple there, she quickly bound up her hair, and from her high window fell. The people found her dead, and their tears began to shed. Why she jumped, there was none that could tell. The bride was dressed in white, was on their wedding night, and now she was fast asleep. Lady Margaret's ghost arrived about midnight, and she stood at their own bed feet. Oh, how do you like your bride so sweet? And how do you like her silken sheets? I'd have given my life to be your wedded wife, but a new love's now in your arms asleep. Very well do I like my bride so sweet, and very well do I like her sheets. But 10,000 times more I love the Lady Margaret, who's a-standing at my own bed feet. Very well I like my bride so sweet, and very well do I like her sheets. Oh yes, 10,000 times more I love the Lady Margaret, who's a-standing at my own bed feet. When that night was past, with morning coming on, he was troubled by that strange, strange dream. He wrote to Lady Margaret's and he knocked on her door. Her mother, dressed in black, began to scream. Lady Margaret's not in her high sewing room, nor is she in her own courtyard, but she's lying in her coffin so narrow and long, her skin now seems so pale and hard. Her mother took him in to see her lying there, and he rolled back her silken shroud. He bent and he kissed her cold clay lips, and his cries could be heard aloud. 10,000 times I've kissed these lips so warm, and just as often they've kissed mine. Save her linen burial cloth, please save it for me. Lady Margaret, in death I'll soon join.